我也不算很年轻啦，48岁了啊，要多两年就50岁了啊。说我我是吴义华牧师啊，说你们比较不熟的话，我就跟你们做一个introduction 哦，
介绍
啊。我有一个老婆才了哈，但是3个孩子哦。我的大女儿叫做善宇啊，儿子叫做正宇，女儿叫做恩宇，哦。但是哦，那个名取得很美哦，那个姓哦就完蛋了，因为是吴嘛，什么都没有了。是不是无是没有，是不是？是了哈，我的华文就是7788这样了哈，这个9910就是要他来代替了哈。所以我的那个讲道会大多是用英文，我就靠这个先生在这里帮我，对吗？是不是先生？这个
可以。
OK, come let us pray. Dear Lord, we give thanks to you for this time.
天父，我们献上感恩。
We pray and ask the Lord that your word shall give us guidance.
求主你以你的话语来引领我们。
And lead us in the right paths.
指导我们走正直的路。
In Jesus' name.
奉耶稣的名。
Amen.
Amen.
Today is Father's Day. So let the slides, please.
Yeah.
The slides.
Oh,
okay, how? Okay. All right. Yeah, today is Father's Day.
今天是父亲节。
Yeah, so let me start off today's sermon with some bad father's jokes.
哎，你们都听得懂哦，不用翻译啊。让我用一段冷笑话开始这篇正道。
I asked, I couldn't find any Chinese, I'm not very good in finding Chinese jokes, so I asked Reverend Sean.
他对这个中文的这些笑话不是很熟悉，所以他就问了许逊然牧师。
And he showed me this picture.
他就让他看这个图片。
And then I looked at it, I said, what's so funny?
他看了就问，哎，有什么有趣的事吗？
Then he explained to me why.
他就解释了。
而父亲节 right? But 那个这父亲哦，是 to pay off the debts.
你们都看得懂了吗？
看得懂哦，说父亲，我们是 here to pay off debts 的。
父亲就是要出钱的。
付钱的 ，OK all right, yeah. Well, we have been doing the character studies in the book of Esther.
我们一直都是在研读这个以斯帖记。
哎，你是9910的对吗？
对。因为 Esther 跟以斯帖根本没有关系的，
以斯帖是谁？
所以一直转不过来。
Okay, all right. Yeah. And today we will be focusing on the character of Mordecai.
所以今天呢，我们会注重的这个人物呢，就是摩迪凯。
Well, it's very interesting that in the passage of Esther, we can see that it ends off with praising Mordecai.
有趣的是，这本书《以西帖记》结尾却是对摩迪凯进行了赞美。
And the verse that was read to us, shows it very clearly that he's esteemed.
所以刚才我们听到的这个经文，也让我们看到他到底是有多么被尊敬。
Because he worked for the good of the people, he spoke up for the welfare of the people.
因为他争取人的福益，他也为他的后代谋求幸福。
So let us take this time to explore in depth the character of Mordecai, so that we can learn collectively how what are some of the lessons we can learn from his life.
所以这时候就让我们再深入的来探讨这位人物，从中学习一些功课。
Well, this man is a Jew, right? He is from the tribe of Benjamin with a royal bloodline.
所以摩迪凯到底是谁呢？他是犹太人，他是来自便雅悯支派，他有王室的血统。
Other famous people from the tribe, for example, the Apostle Paul, the Prophet Jeremiah.
其他著名的便雅悯人呢，有使徒保罗，有先知耶利米。
Well, we all know the story of how he came to adopt Esther.
我们也听过了他这个领养他的孤儿表妹以斯帖的这个故事。
How she was selected and she so-called won the beauty contest and became the queen.
她如何被选择，她也在这个选美大赛中赢得了，然后也赢得了王的心。
And also we heard of how Mordecai learned about the assassination plot.
我们也读到了这个摩迪凯发现有人要刺杀国王。
And then we know that he went on to pass on the news to Queen Esther, who then warned the king.
我们也读到了他如何把这样的消息告诉了这个以斯帖王后，然后也警惕了国王。
And we also know of the story of Haman, who was one of the highest position in the court.
我们也读到了这位高官，他的名字叫哈曼。
And how he Mordecai would not bow to him.
我们也知道摩迪凯不选择跪拜哈曼。
And of course, Haman, being as small-minded as he is, decided to not just kill Mordecai, but also to exterminate the whole Jewish race.
Haman 就是一位小心眼的人啊，他因为摩迪凯不跪拜他，他就生气了，他甚至要消灭整个犹太人。
But we also know how God has turned this whole situation on Haman's head.
我们也看到了这个上帝是如何转变整个局势。
And then later on, what happened was that the king got to know of this plot. Instead, he elevated Mordecai and he punished Haman.
所以当这个国王知道了这样的一个刺杀的阴谋的时候，他提升了摩迪凯。他也处罚了哈曼。
Well, the book of Esther therefore ends off with this glowing testimony, right, of Mordecai. But have you ever wondered the authenticity of this person?
我们看到了在这个以斯帖记里面，摩迪凯受到了尊崇。但是我们会问，到底摩迪凯是不是一个真实的人物呢？
Well, there are some archaeological evidence. For example, in the 1930s, archaeologists working on this site excavated thousands of official records in the form of small clay tablets. They are known as the Persepolis texts.
所以在考古学家的考古里面，在二十世纪三十年代，就发现了数千份这些好像小泥板形式的这个官方的记录，而这些泥板就被称为波斯波利斯文献。
And inside this text, they found a reference to an official named Mordecai, who served during the reign of King Ahasuerus.
就在这些小泥板里面，我们就发现到有摩迪凯这样的一位官员被记录在内，他曾为大流士大帝和薛西斯一世服务。
And so, therefore, it does offer a sense of authenticity to the historical records, because the book of Esther, if we do not already know, is already quite contested with regards to how true it really is.
所以在面对许多这个争议，这个以斯帖是否真实的时候，我们也看到了一些历史的文献来证实摩迪凯这位人物是真实的人物。
So let us look at the person of Mordecai right now, and there are three lessons that I'd like to share.
这时候就让我们来看看摩迪凯这个人物，然后我们可以学习些什么。
Well, the first thing that I'd like to present is that he's a man of godly conduct. He's a man that had the courage to correct others, and he's a man with concern for others.
摩迪凯他的品行是虔诚正义，他的品德是勇敢正直，然后他的品性是热心关怀。
Well, so let's go on to the first point, his conduct that was godly.
我们先来看看他虔诚正义的品行。
Well, the first aspect that we can see is that his act of adopting Esther as his own daughter.
我们首先就来看他收养了以斯帖成为他的养女。
Well, we can see that God's heart is very close to those who are orphaned and to show compassion, especially relatives.
我们都知道上帝的心意是非常看重孤儿的，尤其是我们亲属的孤儿。
So having him to take on and take in an extra responsibility of looking after a child is something that is very commendable.
所以他愿意这样的付出来领养一个女儿，是值得我们尊敬的。
I believe not only did he act on the compassion of his heart for the relative, but also upon the words of God in showing care and to look after those who are orphaned.
我相信他这样做不仅仅是对他的 表妹这个孤儿的一个怜悯，她也是回应了上帝的话语。
Well, I would like to share a very quick story. 我怎么赢adopt 是怎么讲？
领养
啊，领养一只猫 ，OK， 不是领养一个孩子啊，猫哦，猫。
领养猫
啊，三个狗了。
我翻译他的华文啊，好吗？还是
七七八八，你九九四四嘛，哦 ，OK。So basically， 我的大女儿啊，善宇啊，就是很喜欢猫啊，她就两年前啊，就一直跟我讲哦，哇，她要猫，但是我是狗人，哎，不是，我是喜欢狗的人。OK， 我是比较喜欢狗的人啊，所以我已经养了一只狗15年这样了，但是它去世啊，说心很痛。但是狗很乖嘛，对不对？你叫它来，它就来；你叫它坐，它就坐；叫它跳，它就跳。啊，叫它安静，它可能不会安静了啊。但是你每次开门的话，它就跑过来跟你，对不对？猫不是这样的，猫你叫它来，它就躺在那边啊。你开门，它只是来找你哦。它肚子饿的时候，它就喵喵喵跟你喵啊，对不对？喵不停啊，连你喂完它了，它就自己去睡觉了。啊，我就觉得哈、哦、猫哈、哦、真的是好像不是很贴心这样的感觉啦，所以我就跟他讲不要猫，你 know 啊，又有猫哦，又要有加钱呐、啊，又要什么啦，又吃啦什么啦，看医生啊什么，但是他就是很 determined，
他很坚决
啊，很坚决哦，他很坚决，然后、哦、for 这两年哦，他就一直我们的那个 family devotion，
我们在家庭的灵修的时候
祷告的时候，他就会。假假啦、啊、不是假假真真啦、啊啊、上帝啊英文啊不是华文 给我爸爸、哦、他的心、哦啊、换一下、啊、他会爱猫、啊、这样啊就这样一直祷告了两年呢
好厉害哦、
啊、这是两年了、啊、然后最后、哦、就有一个机会啦这只猫、哦、就来了啦、因为、Foster 是跟 Adopt 不一样 Foster 跟 Adopt 不一样、
哦、
Foster 只是 short term 才、
哦
啊就是、
寄养、
啊、只是 短期的啦、啊、上讲哇可能有这只猫、可以寄养啦一 短的啦然后、啊、我就讲 OK 要短的咯然后我们试试看啦我就在那边祷告、啊、讲这让这只猫、哦、是 很不好的猫、啊、所以我的女儿就会死心、啊、我就这样祷告、啊、但是、哦、那个猫一来、哦、哇乖啊很乖啊你叫它名它也来它又不乱的 scratch
抓、
啊、抓那些东西、啊、地方，他只抓他该抓的地方，啊，人又很干净，那狗它的你 know 它的口水乱乱飞，那猫很干净，人又很香，没有味道，人又很乖在那边，啊，就是很贴心啦，然后最后 OK 啦，I think 神、哦、比较喜欢我的女儿啦，所以他 fulfill 他的 prayer not mine、yeah.。
他女儿的祷告蒙上帝垂听
要领养一只猫、哦、都要想这样多嘞、
嗯、
你看sorry 我应该讲英文了
继续吧继续吧很好很好
So adopting a cat already takes up so much effort you talk about Mother Kai adopting a child as own daughter
领养一只猫已经这么麻烦了要 要领养一个人、那个负担是很大的哈。
So we can see that his conduct was one that he truly wanted to be righteous. He wanted to do what is right for this child, and he wanted to do right, what is right before God.
所以他的品行就是他真的是要做正确的事，他也要做上帝所喜悦的事。
And then the next point that we see is that when he received news of the plot.
另外一点就是我们看到当他发现到有这样一个刺杀的阴谋的时候
and then what we see here is that you know he is a subject of the Persian Empire
这里我们要知道他是被降服的臣民
yeah and what happened here is that if let's say I'm him you know if someone wants to kill that king right I will keep quiet lah
所以我是被降服的臣民如果有人要刺杀这个国王那我应该是安静了不是更好吗
我在那边偷笑了对不对、but then what he did was righteous. He continued to pass on the news and warn the king.
但他选择做的事却是正义的，他反而要警惕这个国王。
And then the next point is that even though the news of such a thing was passed on the king and it was averted, he didn't claim any glory.
当这个消息 传给王的时候，而这个刺杀的阴谋败坏之后，他却没有要讨功。
Yeah, he just did what he needed to do with little fanfare.
他就是做该做的事，也没有敲锣打鼓。
不像我了，我做了一点点好的事就要快点放 Facebook 了。
做了好事就要放在脸书长脸
跑完五公里哇很好拍一下哇这样是不是有时就是这样了我们人有时就是这样了不是你们是我了就做了一点好事就要快点给人家懂了哇你多厉害了多傻了但But then we need to reflect as a father as I reflect as a father
但是当我们作为父亲让我们反思
It's a constant reminder to conduct myself righteously as the head of the household.
我们要不断提醒自己，我们的品行要像一家之主。
And a role model in making righteous decisions that pleases God ultimately.
我们要树立一个讨上帝喜悦、做正确决定的一个榜样。
It's not always easy, but I'm glad that I allow my children to scold me and say wrong things, not say wrong things, to point out my mistakes.
这并不是那么容易的，但我很高兴，我愿意让我的孩子来指出我犯错的时候。
Because we all have blind spots lah, even as a parent, right? They can see certain perspectives of our lives, and then they can remind us.
因为我们都有盲点的哈，身为父亲，我们也是有盲点，我需要别人来指出我们的盲点。
It's also a reminder of my purpose of doing what is right.For my children, by teaching them the right conduct, what's my purpose?
也不断地提醒我们，我要让我的孩子知道如何做正确的事情，我的目的是什么。
You see, sometimes as parents, yes, I think most of the time our desire for our kids to be taught well, to be taught in the right ways of life is pure, and I believe it is something that we want for the best of them.
身为父母亲，我们希望我们的孩子健康，我们希望我们的孩子做得很好，凡事都做得很杰出，这个目的是好的。
Yeah, but sometimes, ultimately, sometimes I think, not ultimately, sometimes there could be that sense whereby we do see our children as some form of trophies.
但是很多时候，或者有些时候，我们会不会把我们孩子当成是我们的战利品呢？
And therefore, our motivation of teaching them right seems to be sometimes could be subtly, subconsciously within us, making us look good.
So, 有的时候我们希望我们的孩子做正确的事情，其实我们心里是要有点炫耀之心。
And sometimes it's like, 哇哇，你的孩子很乖，哇，你很厉害嘞，你做得很好啊，哇，你教导很好，哇，你的家很好啊，啊，这样啊，你看啊。But that shouldn't be the motivation, all right? That shouldn't be. The motivation is that we want to do it because it's right before God, all right? Our conduct must be right. How our children receive it, we do the best that we can to pour into their lives, but we shouldn't put them as the trophy, like as if they are the barometer of our failures or our success as parents.
所以我们的动机不是要让别人来夸我们是好父亲，就好像是我们的孩子到底做得多好，就是代表我们有多成功，而是我们这样做是为了要讨上帝的喜悦。
Let's go to the second point.
我们再看第二点。
He had the courage to correct.
他勇敢正直，他愿意提起勇气纠正错误。
He refused to bow to Haman. His conviction was that he would never bow to anyone other than God.
他拒绝向哈曼低头跪拜，他的确信就是除了上帝以外，他不会跪拜任何人。
Even when the edict was issued to exterminate, instead of cowering in fear, he stood by his decision courageously.
即使他要面对一些关乎他生命的事情的时候，他还是勇敢地做出正确的决定。
Well, the next point was that we see that he also had the courage to correct the queen.
另外一点，我们也看到他有勇气去纠正以斯帖。
Now, despite the fact that she is his daughter, but the fact is that right now she's the queen. He is her subject.
即使以斯帖曾经是他的养女，但是他现在已经成为了王后，他这时候的身份就是一个臣子。
And he was not afraid to correct her by reminding her, by reprimanding her, for example, in the very famous passage, "Do not think that because you are in the king's house, you alone of all the Jews will escape." I think this is very reprimanding, you know. "For if you remain silent at this time, relief and deliverance for the Jews will arise from another place, but you and your father's family will perish. And who knows but that you have come to your royal position for such a time as this."
他也用了严厉的话来谴责以西帖，他的话是这样的，不要自己以为在王宫里强过任何犹太人，得以幸免。此时你若闭口不言，犹太人必从别处得解脱，蒙拯救，你和你父家必致灭亡。焉知你得了王后的位分，不是为现今的机会吗？
And so we can see that even though they have a relationship with one another, yes, but she's now at a different level. She's the queen. She's higher than Mordecai, or so she thinks, lah.
即使他们过去就是有一个养父养女的关系，但是毕竟现在她是王后和臣子的关系，她是王后了。
So a reflection as a father is this.That I feel, I think, and some of us have experienced that our children will come to a point where they think that they are their own kings and queens of their own life.
所以作为一个父亲的反思，总有一天我们的孩子会长大的，他们能够独立自主，自己来做决定，并可能成为他们自己心中的王或者王后，已经不是公主了哈。
And we will say that, you know, 公主, okay,
not princess anymore.
Princess, not princess anymore.
以前是可爱的公主, 现在是王后。
也是可爱的王后了。
可爱的, okay.
Yeah. And so when we view that, we say, "Aiya, you are an adult already. You go and make your decision lah. I've done all I can already. You should know what to do lah."
所以有时候我们会认为说，哎呀，你已经长大了，你就自己做决定吧。
But for Mordecai, no, he still came in. He did not force her.But he laid it out plainly, reprimanded her based on facts, rationale, and bringing in God's work and God's sovereign plan in the matter.
但是我们看到摩迪凯并没有这样做，他还是带着上帝的话语，带着该做正确的事情的这个教训来指责以斯帖。
So we can see that.He did not shy away and had the courage to continue to correct what is wrong in her life despite her status at that point of time.
所以她并没有因为自己是臣子而女儿养女是王后而没有去指出她的错误。
Such a time as this.
现今就是机会了。
As fathers, sometimes I wonder, are you also feeling that way, that we are placed in such a time as this?
所以身为父亲，我不知道你会不会有时候会想到，现今就是我的机会了。
Sometimes, who teach you to be a father? No one, what? Right, who teach you? You can go through a course on how to graduate to be a father. Don't have what? Right, all of us have to learn, right?
有人教你怎么做父亲吗？有没有去考什么证书？做父亲的证书。
Yeah, and so all of us in one way or another are placed into such a times as this.
所以我们每个人都是上帝把我们摆放在现今的这个机会。
And therefore we learn, and we have to learn, and we learn from the Lord, and we cannot shirk our responsibility no matter how tough or uncomfortable it may be.
所以我们要学习，我们要向我们的上帝学习，无论我们要遭遇的困难是如何的艰巨。
Final point,
最后一点
godly concern, concern for others.
品行就是要热心关怀。
Now, as mentioned, Mordecai had a great concern for Esther. All right, he looked after her. He brought her up. Even when she was selected to be part of the harem, he continued to watch out for her day and night.
我们知道摩迪凯对这个他的孤儿表妹以斯帖的关心，他对待她如同对待自己的儿女一样抚养长大。即使他被选为后宫的一员的时候，他仍然日夜的守护着他。
Now in chapter 2, verse 11, it says, every day he walked back and forth near the courtyard of the harem to find out how Esther was and what was happening to her.
在二章十一节是这样说的，莫迪凯天天在女院前徘徊，要知道以斯帖是否平安，过得如何。
And we also can see that the concern was mutual between Esther and Mordecai. And so when Mordecai was distressed, Esther was also concerned and tried to find out what happened to him.
我们也可以看到他们彼此之间是相互关心的。以斯帖也关心发生在莫迪凯身上的事。所以当莫迪凯为王的一道旨意苦恼的时候，以斯帖也很担心，并试图找出他到底苦恼些什么。
For example, in chapter 4, verse 4 and 5, it says this, when Esther's eunuchs and female attendants came to her and told her about Mordecai, she was in great distress. She sent clothes for him to put on instead of the sackcloth, but he would not accept them. Then Esther summoned Hathach, one of the king's eunuchs assigned to her, and ordered him to find out what was troubling Mordecai and why.
以斯帖四章四节是这样说的，以斯帖王后和宫女和太监来把这事告诉以斯帖，她非常忧愁，就送衣服给莫迪凯穿，要他脱下身上的麻衣，他却不肯接受。
So I believe that their relationship, their connection of concern for one another must have been born out of years of connection with one another.
因此我们可以看到他们对彼此的关心是强烈的，而且我相信这并非是理所当然的。我相信他们彼此间的这个关系是建立在牢固的联系中，这样的关系是自然流露出来的。
So my reflection as a father is this, that some will say it is not about the quantity of time, but the quality of time that I spend with my children. I disagree.
作为父亲的一个反思就是这样的，有人会说作为父母亲重要的不是时间的多寡，而是与他们共度时光的质量，但是我个人是不同意的。
How can you get quality time without that quantity time? We cannot engineer out quantity time. Let me give you an example. If let's say you think, oh, this week I'm so busy. Okay, I left with 2 hours in this week. It will be quality time with my family. Okay, family, come. Okay, now, next Thursday, okay, 12 to 2 p.m., I'm free. We will make it quality time. Okay, let's make sure it's quality time, okay? It does not work that way. It's not a formula. 我有写是吗？
有。Okay. 我都忘了我要翻译。没有足够的时间，何来高质量的时间呢？我们是没有办法去设计高质量的时间的，这不是我们能设定的。比如说我这周很忙，所以我就告诉我的孩子们，我们下周是12点到2点，我们一起吃饭好吗？让我们一起来，我们确保这段时间是高质量的时间好吗？你觉得会发生吗？事情不是这样的。
And so my wife is a stay-home homemaker for the past 10 years.
我的太太十年就是做家庭主妇。
主妇啊，
对吗？
主那个丈夫啊。Anyway, what I'm trying to say is this, is that it was a conscious decision that was made together because my wife also had a desire to stay home, and although finances were stretched, but things still worked out.
虽然这样的话经济上是有点困难，但是这是我和太太共同的一个决定。
And I, as my children grew, and I always remember that my children now, they will tell us, wow, we are very blessed to have a mother at home. You are very blessed to have a mother at home.
当我的孩子渐渐长大的时候，有时会听到我的孩子说，我们家中有我们的母亲在是一个祝福来的。
And in that, with that quantity time, there's that ability to have that quality time as it surfaces.
就在这样花很多时间里面，高质量的时间就产生了。
Again, I'm not saying that we all must go and quit our jobs now lah, and that sort of thing lah. But I understand all of us have different circumstances. Okay, but what I'm trying to say is that we need to be more cognizant of the fact that we need to spend time. All right, we need to eradicate those extra things that may eat up the time that we have, so that we can spend time with the family.
这里牧师没有建议大家辞职哈，啊，不是辞职然后留在家里。我们各有不同的这样的一个啊需要，需要去处理。但是牧师要提醒大家的是，我们是不是能够把一些没有这么重要的事情放在一边，然后尽量花更多的时间和我们的家人在一起。
所以哦，好像我跟我的儿子哦，我们就会花那些不必要花的时间呐，就是玩电脑啦。哦啊，说我假如自己玩电脑的话，就干脆叫他一起来玩喽。啊，这样我们就可以一起笑啊骂啊什么啦，就一起玩，就是一起玩，就是这样啊，找这种 platform 啦啊 ，common platforms， to common platforms。
Yeah 啊。你们懂什么是 platform 吗？就是一起玩游戏，一起做事情啦哈。好，你在做什么？如果你的孩子可以跟你一起做的话，就一起做。这样的话就不没有说要额外的时间在一起了吗
？Yeah, very good. 这个我没有写，你还讲得这样好。Okay, okay. So, like for example, one night I was playing Xbox with my son. Xbox, and then
有一天我在玩这个电子游戏的时候
，then 我们就讲，哎呀，要去厕所。Toilet break.
对对对，你讲了，
厕所厕所。
So confusing. Yeah.
我们就讲要去厕所。OK, then 他就先进去了，他就先进去，我在外面等了。因为很晚了嘛，不能进去那个主人房的啊，就去那个厕所的咯。哎，不是，就
Kitchen 的
啊的厨所。然后就进去
了，厨房，
他就出来，他就出来，连我，他就问我一个很怪的问题耶。他就问我一个什么Bible 的问题嘞，然后我就讲 OK 咯 ，since 他有 interest to 问的嘛，我就回答了。但是我有点尿急，但是不用紧啊，就继续讲啊，我就在那边继续讲啊，就是跟他讲哇，一讲哦，他就站在那个门口那边，在堂柱那边，然后我就在那个煮饭的那个 counter 这边，然后就讲哦，讲了两个钟头嘞，他就问这个，就 link 去那个，然后就 link 去我的 live， 就 link 去他的 live， 然后 link 去女孩子，然后就 link 去什么朋友，什么都 link 到完喽，啊，感谢主，我的尿哦还可以憋了，yeah, 但是 what I'm trying to say is this， 就是我们。这种 quality time， 我们 quantity time， 我们 spend together， 就是这种 special moment， 我们要 catch to become a quality time， 哦。
所以注意听了哈，就是在我们在花时间相处的时候，有时会出现一些特别的时光。当这些特别的时光出现的时候，我们要捕抓住，这就成为我们高质量的时间了。
Quantity as much as quality time， connection will build the concern。We must be concerned for others, especially for our children.
记得哈，我们必须要有充足的时间和高质量的时间，这两样事情都是一样重要的。因为当我们有联系的时候，我们才会建立关心。我们必须关心他人，尤其是我们自己的孩子。
Well, in conclusion, we have looked at Mordecai, and collectively, we have gleaned spiritual lessons from his life, regardless of whether we are fathers or not.
无论我们是否身为人父，我们都一起从摩迪凯的一生中，我们吸取了一些属灵的教训。
So we see that he has conducted himself righteously. He had the courage to correct the wrongs, and he showed concern for others.
我们看到他如何的，在他收养他的孩子以西铁的身上，看到他的品行是怎么虔诚的正义，他的品德是勇敢的正直，还有他的品性是热心关怀。
And we have also seen how this reminders explicitly, specifically, addresses us as roles as fathers.
我们也探讨了这些功课如何提醒我们，应用在我们的作为父亲的角色上。
So regardless of who we are in our station of life, let us commit this time to respond to God.
但是无论我们是处在怎样的人生阶段，就让我们现在花一点时间来回应上帝。
Maybe it's an area that we need to grow in our conduct.
可能是我们在我们的品行上，我们要 更加的虔诚正义。
Maybe it's an area that we need to have more courage to be able to correct lovingly someone that we love.
可能是我们的品德，我们是不是会比较勇敢正直一点去纠正一些错误的事情。
Or maybe it's an area that we need to have a heart of more concern for others.
或者我们可能必须对我们周围的人多一点热心，多一些关怀。
So at this point of time, I'd like us to be still, be quiet. It's your time with God. Don't look anywhere else and just say this prayer to God as the Spirit leads you. Be it an area of change in your conduct, be it an area of courage to be able to correct others, or is it an area of the heart of concern for others? Allow the Spirit to speak to you and respond to God in your prayers.
让我们此时此刻就安静我们自己好吗？我们来寻求，我们来聆听，可能圣灵要告诉我们，我们在品行上我们可以做得更好的，或者在品德上我们可以更勇敢正直，或者在品性上我们可以多一点热心，多一点关怀。就安静在上帝的面前，接着祷告，聆听圣灵向你说话。
I'll give us a few moments before I close in prayer.
我再给大家一点时间，之后我会做一个结束的祷告。
Dear Lord, we come before you as broken people.
天父上帝，我们带着破碎的心来到你面前。
Lord, you are the perfect Father.
上帝，你是完美的上天父。
We are imperfect, but Lord, in you, we strive to be perfect.
我们是不完全的，但是在你里面，我们要追求完全。
So help us as you hear and you heard the prayers of your children.
帮助我们垂听我们的祷告。
Pray that we will continue to grow in our conduct to be one that is righteous and godly.
我们祷告，让我们在品行上我们追求虔诚正义。
And also help us to have that courage to correct wrongs in our lives and wrongs in other people's lives lovingly.
赐给我们勇气，让我们带着爱心去纠正别人的错误，也纠正我们自己的错误。
And also to show concern lovingly to others.
也帮助我们以爱心、以热心去关怀我们身边的人。
At this point of time, before I close in prayer, being Father's Day, I would like to invite the fathers to stand.
在结束祷告之前，今天是父亲节，我请所有的父亲这时候站立。
And I'd like to pray a prayer of blessings for the fathers, and also invite the church to stretch out your hands to pray for our fathers.
我们这时候要祝福这些父亲们，我也请所有的弟兄姐妹们伸出你的手来为他们祷告。
Dear Lord, we give thanks to you for the fathers that are standing in our midst.
主啊，我们为这所有站立在这里的父亲们献上感恩。
We pray and ask that Lord that you will instill in us a righteous spirit.
主啊，赐给我们正义的灵。
Guard our hearts.
保守我们的心。
So that life can flow through us.
让生命流露。
Let that life that comes from you flow through us.
从你而来的生命从我们的身上流露出来。
Help us, Lord, because the responsibility is great.
求你帮助我们，因为这个责任是重大的。
We may not know how to do, what to do, and when to do most times.
我们不知道该做什么，何时做什么。
But Lord, you know.
但是主你是知道的。
So grant us wisdom.
所以求你赐给我们智慧。
grant us the ability to make right decisions.
赐给我们做正确决定的能力。
To lead and guide the family.
来带领，来引导我们的家人。
We commit ourselves to you.
我们把自己交托在你的手中。
In Jesus' name.
奉耶稣的名。
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
谢谢，请坐。
我们一起站立。